two grandchildren, Diane Preblick, who's over in high school, and I have Casey Preblick that's here in the middle school. So I've been here for quite a number of years. But I wanted to kind of draw on what John just said and bring all of you up to date a little bit. Do you all know what's going on this coming Saturday? Do you know where Rock Spring Park is?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, at noon time, we're gonna have the memorial service up at Rock Spring Park. So we'd love to see all of you up there with your families, and we're gonna pay honor to the ones that couldn't be here today. Some of them fallen soldiers, and some of them have just passed away. But all of them have one thing in common, they all served their country. One of the things that John said, and I'm gonna pick up on a little bit, is you never know where you're gonna go in life. I went through the local schools here. I was from Morris Plains, so I went through Bailey Ellard High School, I went through St. Virgil's School and everything. And I really didn't have any purpose in my life, and I really didn't do well in school. That was my own doing, stupidity on my part, but I would rather play ball and party than to go to school and get good grades. There came a time after high school when everybody was applying to colleges, so I did the same exact thing. And I applied to all of the colleges, all the small, tiny little colleges, Notre Dame, USC, Seton Hall, all of those schools I applied to, and I was summarily turned down by every single one of them. How many students in this class are going to be 18 years old shortly? You're all 17 or 16 or 14, 17?
14.
Oh, 14. Oh, I'm sorry. Okay. When you reach 18 years of age, you know you have to register with the government. Is that correct? You have to file for the Selective Service. Well, at the time of my upbringing, when I turned that age, the Selective Service was called the draft. So everybody that applied for Selective Service was included in the draft. And in 1966, I just happened to get drafted. Didn't know what I was doing, very patriotic because all my family had been in the services. And I didn't have anything against the services. I didn't think I was going to be eligible to go, but unbeknownst to me, I was. And next thing I know, after a little basic training, which didn't amount to a whole lot at that point in time, they were really gathering a lot of the people together from all over the country and putting them in different units to send them over to Vietnam. You all know where Vietnam is, or you'll learn about it anyway. Some of your grandfathers were probably there, or some of your uncles. But next thing I know, I found myself on a ship on the way to Vietnam. One thing I will say is all during school, we're done. At that point in time, all through school, I was the type of a person, I didn't care for bullying. I think you all know what that is. I didn't care for that in my school. So I always, anybody that was being bullied, I always went to their defense. It cost me a little bit to do that, but I didn't care. You know, I stood up to the bullies. When I got into the service, I was afraid the same thing was going to happen, because you're thrown in with hundreds of different men, you know, throughout the area, and I thought, this is going to continue. It did continue in basic training, but it did not continue after I got out of my basic training. Everybody was a comrade. I had everybody's back. They had my back.